I want to show you another formula that is basically just another name for the Pythagorean theorem, and it's called the distance formula. Now, what makes the distance formula special is that it can find the distance between any two points. Let's take two points. The point 4, 3, let's see, over 4 and up 3, right? And the point negative 1, negative 3. So we'll go back 1 and down 3. And we want the distance between those two points. I want to know that exact distance, that red segment, if you would. And we'll call that distance, for now, x. And since we've gone to the trouble of, which took a long time, I might add, of drawing a graph grid, we can hopefully, if you look hard, can see that there is a right triangle with that side x as the hypotenuse. And we can easily, since it's on a graph, measure the legs. One of them is 6, and one of them is 5. Take the time and go ahead and measure the units. There's 6 units on the right and 5 units on the bottom, which means we can use the Pythagorean theorem. You may remember is 6 squared, one leg squared, plus 5 squared, the other leg squared, equals the hypotenuse squared. Now, we can calculate what these numbers are. 6 squared is 36, 5 squared is 25, and they're supposed to add up to x squared. Well, they do add up to 61. So if 61 is x squared, the way we would find x would be to take the square root of both sides to get x by itself. And that would make x, in this case, equal to the square root of 61. And if we used our calculator, we could get a decimal estimate, which would be about 7.81, which seems reasonable. What I mean is, if looking at the picture, if I got 78.1, I go, all right, I'm mad, something's wrong here, kind of a thing. Okay, well, we didn't need to learn anything new here. We just used the Pythagorean theorem because we went to the trouble of drawing the graph. But what can we do it without a graph? Same points now. Consider, I'll bring the graph back just for reference, the two x coordinates of these two points. If I subtract them, 4 minus a negative 1, remember what happens when you subtract a negative, 4 minus negative 1, we'll get 5. Remember where that was? That was the bottom leg. Of course, that was the distance between the two x values. And if we did the same thing with the two y values, y part of the first point y minus y part of the second point, or 3 minus negative 3, we'll get the other leg. The difference between the y values is the y side, which is, of course, 6. And we can then use the Pythagorean theorem. 6 squared plus 5 squared, same thing we did before, equals x squared. Calculate the multiplications, add them up, take the square root of both sides, and get the same answer without drawing the graph. That's the point. Now, that, what we just did, is the distance formula. As crazy as it may seem, it's the difference between the x coordinates of the two points, x1 minus x2, and then squared it, remember that's what we did, added to the difference between the y coordinates, and then squared it, and then at the very end, remember what we did. We took the square root. That nightmare, what you're looking at, is the distance formula, and it exists to find the distance between any two points without drawing a graph. Now, you could always sketch a graph if you get confused and use the Pythagorean theorem, because that's just what this is, just another form of the Pythagorean theorem. Okay, let's do one more, and this time we'll do it blind. We're not going to be able to see the graph. We're going to find the distance between the points negative 2, 4 and 2, negative 1 using this distance formula. That's what it's for. Well, let's see. We subtract the x coordinates. So let's see, negative 2 minus 2 And I hope you know that is negative 4. Now then you're worried, aren't you, because you see a negative. But hold on. Let's subtract the y coordinates. 4 minus the negative 1. And in this case, 4 minus negative 1, we get a 5. Now that negative is going to get taken care of because we called that we're going to square these answers. Negative 4, which is what the x1 minus x2 is, squared. We'll add to that the 5 squared. And look what we get. 16, hi mom, positive 16 added to 25. And if we add them up, we get 41. And don't forget, we need to take the square root. So the resulting hypotenuse, or distance if you would be the square root of 41, which is about 6.4. Again, it's in the range, it seems reasonable, and I can prove to you, in fact, that it is. Just in case you don't believe that we can do the Pythagorean theorem with using this formula without a graph, let's do the same 2 points with a graph, and hopefully we'll get the same answer. Negative 2, 4, going back 2 and up 4, and 2, 1, going over 2 and down 1. That distance we'll call x. Now that we have the graph, we can actually count the legs. The left leg is, as you count, 5 boxes. We got it through subtraction earlier, but with the picture, if we go to the trouble of drawing the picture, we can actually count the size. And the bottom is, son of a gun, it is 4. Again, before we used the distance formula to just subtract and get it. But with the picture, we can verify, in fact, that it is 4. And if we plug these into the Pythagorean theorem, 4 squared plus 5 squared equals that hypotenuse squared, son of a gun, we get the same numbers and the same sum of 41 being x squared. Of course, don't forget, we have to take the square root of both sides, and yet again, we get that x is the square root of 41, or 6.4. So, if you have a graph, go ahead and draw your points and use the Pythagorean theorem. But if you don't want to go to that trouble, you can just use the distance formula and get it in that way. Okay, dig in with that homework. And don't forget to write down the distance formula in your notes.